Today, I am going to tell about the topic known as respiration for 10th bio class. During nutrition, the food material taken in our body or in organisms used in cell to provide energy for various life processes. When food digests in cells, the energy used to various life processes and food convert in the form of energy. In various animals, there are different ways to take energy from the food. In all cases of organism, we can see glucose, or you can say food. Glucose is converted into pyruvate. Glucose is the 6 carbon molecules which convert into pyruvate. Pyruvate is the 3 carbon molecules. This process takes place or completed in cytoplasm, cell cytoplasm. When glucose converts into pyruvate, this process and energy is also released in this process. This function takes place in all cases of organism, or you can say this reaction or this process is properly found in all animals. When after this, or you can say further, pyruvate in case of yeast, if pyruvate absence of in absence of oxygen, or when yeast does not taste oxygen, pyruvate convert into ethanol, which is 2 carbon molecules, and it also gives carbon dioxide and some amount of energy. If pyruvate convert in ethanol, carbon dioxide and energy in absence of oxygen, then we call this reaction anaerobic respiration. And in case of our muscles, if pyruvate convert into 3 carbon molecules, lactic acid and energy and lack of oxygen in our muscles, when we work hardly, after some time be unable to work because our muscles, in our muscles, pyruvate converts into lactic acid due to the deposition of lactic acid. Be tired and sometimes we cannot do any work. In case of mitochondria, which are found in our cell, and if they utilize oxygen or they use oxygen, then pyruvate convert into carbon dioxide, water and energy. If in case oxygen is used, then it can say aerobic respiration. So respiration is divided into 2 types. In case of absence of oxygen, this is known as anaerobic respiration, and they use oxygen, then it is known as aerobic respiration. So respiration is 2 types. And in last, in every case, we are seeing here energy is formed. This energy is stored in our consciousness inside in the form of ATP. If ATP add 1 phosphate, then it converted into state ATP which is the energy molecules and when there is necessary to the working of energy then ATP converts it release one phosphate and release also energy which is used in our life process. In case of human being, human respiratory system, there is a structure, human respiratory system. First, here nasal passage, we breathe our, breathe air or through nostrils and mouth, both but nostril. Passage of nostril is very important. And mouth is into your throat. Respiration through mouth is not useful. So nasal is important for respiration. If we respire our air or intake of our oxygen or air from environment, in passage of nostril there are some hairs and mucus which controls or which controls to go microorganisms in our body and sandy particles also sits by the mucus. So nasal passage is essential or to our respiratory system and they help to in respiration. After this air goes through pharynx, trachea. In trachea there is a special organ which are swelling in nature known as larynx and further we go to the side of lungs. There are many type of structure which are made of cartilage known as rings of cartilage. There are 16 to 20 cartilage which are situated in structure. They check to attach our both surface of our trachea. After this trachea is divided into two parts, first one left side and second is right side. Left side goes into left lungs and right to right lungs. Then these branches divide time to time about 25 to 26 times, smaller and smaller becomes, and in last they makes a very thin pipe structure known as bronchioles, and in our bronchioles there is a swelling part or balloon like cell known as alveoli in which air present. In wall of alveoli there are large amount of blood vessels are found in which blood fills, and in blood there is a pigment known as hemoglobin which carries the oxygen. In a alveoli there is exchange of gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange in these balloon like structure known as alveoli by which blood vessels or blood takes oxygen and exit CO2, and exit CO2 passes out to the our nostrils or mouth in air, and there are 12 pairs of ribs are found above our right and left lungs which protects our lungs. And here it is the argon monoxide. It helps in respiration or diaphragm. Go in low side, then area of lungs is increasing, then air enters through nostrils and reaches into lungs. When diaphragm comes in one state or early state, then area of lungs decreases, then air is filled in our alveoli, it passes through nostrils and out in our environment. This structure is known as human respiratory system. So we take in oxygen and carbon dioxide through our lungs, and the organ which are attached to our respiratory system, in this way respiration is complete.